So, dear students, now we learn about the electric cell. Okay, what does it mean? Electric cell is also known as a dry cell. Why it is known as a dry cell? Because it doesn't contain any liquid chemical. It doesn't contain any liquid means all the chemical is present inside the cell is in the powdered form. Okay, powdered form. Okay, and you know the means what are the capacity of a single cell? You know, a single cell contain only 1.5 volts of electricity. Okay, that's why it is much easier to use, it is much safer to use. Okay, but what about the power station? Power station means from where the electricity come from means where the electricity is generated. Okay, so the capacity of power stations having much more voltage, it is just near about, I am approximately, I have noted down here, but it is much more than this reading. Okay, so 220 near about volts is capacity of the power station. So okay, so we are using the bulb, we can use the torch means with the help of one or two or three cells. Okay, some, you know, the electronic toys are also uses with the help of two or three cell. Okay, so that is a safer to use. But what about that appliances that required much more voltage to work properly? Okay, so you know that many devices need more voltage to work. Okay, many devices need more voltage to work. So for high voltage, we need to combine one cell attached with the another one, that is another with the another one. Okay, like that you can say the positive terminal, this one is act as a metal cap, act as a positive terminal, metal disc act as a negative terminal. So negative terminal of the first cell is connected with the positive terminal of the another cell. Okay, and negative terminal of the another cell, or you can say the second cell, is attached with the positive terminal of the third cell. So when we combine together these 1, 2, 3 cell combined together, then there is a formation of a battery. Okay, is it clear to all? Many devices need much more voltage to work properly. For that we required more than two cell. Okay, when we are combining together two or three cell together, then there is a formation of battery. So when we combine together, then it is known as a battery, and battery we are using for high voltage, or you can say that those type of devices who needs high voltage to work properly. I think it is clear to all students. So now we will discuss about the bulb. Okay, yes, now we will discuss about the bulb. Okay, dear students, you generally have seen this type of bulb in your house also. Okay, so we will discuss about something more. Okay, something more about this bulb. Okay, so you know that bulb, outer covering of the bulb is made up of glass. This is a glass, is it clear? And the base is metallic. The base is metallic, it means this base is a metallic. Why it is called metallic, students? So as you know that metal is a very good conductor of electricity, that helps to support the means the fluctuation of electric current into the devices. Okay, you know that the thin wire that gives off light, the thin wire, this is the thin wire, you have seen this. This is a thin wire which is having some spring like in a manner, that are arranged in a spring like manner. So that is called a filament. Okay, that is called a filament. You have seen that filament is made up of tungsten. Okay, it is generally asking 1 marks in the exam that the filament is made up of what, which material. Okay, so your answers will be that the filament which is present inside the bulb, that filament, the thin wire that gives off light, that is known as filament, and it is made up of tungsten. It is made up of tungsten. It is clear? And you know that filament of the bulb is attached with the two thick wire. That is attached with the two thick wire. You know, in the bulb, like a cell, like you, I get known about that there is a two terminal of the bulb also. The positive terminal as well as the negative terminal. The same thing in this bulb also, we have seen that there is a two terminal also which is present in the bulb. Have you seen? It is available in your house and you can take a bulb in your hand and just watch it carefully. Okay, so this is also a terminal, students. This one is terminal and this one is terminal. Okay, these two type of terminal is also present in the bulb, and you have seen that it is arranged in a such a manner that never be attached with the each other. Okay, and you know, when we are just going to connect to switch on that device with the help of cell, that is also helpful for supplying a current, for supplying the electricity. Okay, and you know, this is a glass filament, this is your metallic base and base of the bulb, this is called your base of the bulb, and you know, student, this is your terminal. So my dear students, you can take a experiment in your house. Let's have a look about that, how we can light on, or you can help to glow the bulb of torch. Okay, because in the torch there is a very tiny bulb that needs very less volts. Okay, so we can try it at home also. So just take a cell, just arrange this in a manner. Okay, just take a four types of wire, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, two wire is you have to connect in a such a manner that a positive one wire is connected with the positive terminal, another one is connect with the negative terminal, and I tie it with the help of rubber band. Okay, now another two types of wire you need to connect with that bulb, with that with these two terminal. Okay students, now what will happen? There is no power supply because there is a cut off of these wire. Now what will happen? Now we will just attach with both of these wire, both of end of these wire. Okay, so we are attaching here. Okay, now what will happen? The bulb will glow. How it is possible, student? You know, outside the cell the electric current will flow from positive to negative. So you know that this is act as a negative terminal and this one will act as a positive terminal. So the current will flow here and from positive towards negative, and inside the cell, if we are talking about, then electric current will flow from negative to positive. Okay, why it is happened? Because the circuit should be completed here. The circuit should be completed, only at that time the bulb will help us to glow. We can able to see that bulb will glow. Okay student, there is a completing of circuit. So you can do this type of experiment in your house also. It's a very easy, and I know you just take a very much fun in this. Okay, thank you for watching this video.